Hey everybody, thanks for joining me. I'm Mike Drotis, Bible teacher and preacher, and you have tuned into my YouTube channel, Solving the Prophetic Puzzle. I talk a lot about the rapture. I preach and teach about the rapture. I tell people that the rapture is coming soon. So when somebody asks a question about the rapture, I usually try to answer that question. Recently, somebody asked me, what happens to a believer when they die? Do they sleep in the grave until the rapture? Or do they miss the rapture altogether? Or do they sleep in the grave until the millennial reign is over? What happens to a person, a believer in Christ, who dies before the rapture? Let's look at what the Bible says about the term sleep. In John chapter 11, you remember the story. Jesus' friend Lazarus had died, and Jesus was going to go see Lazarus, and he's telling his disciples about this. And in John chapter 11, verse 11, he says, our friend Lazarus sleeps, but I go that I may wake him. Then the disciples said, Lord, if he sleeps, he will get well. However, Jesus spoke of his death, but they thought he was speaking about taking rest and sleep. Then Jesus said to them plainly, Lazarus is dead. So sometimes in the translation, there's a little bit of confusion here. Then in our great rapture verse, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13, Paul's answering the same question that I'm talking to you about now. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep. In my Bible, there's a little number next to the word asleep. And over in the margin, it says died. So Paul is answering the same question. He's telling them, don't be concerned about those who have already died, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. We have hope in Christ and hope in the rapture. Paul wanted to answer this question and tell them what exactly was going to happen. Verse 14, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, God will bring with him those who have died in Jesus, or those who sleep in Jesus. What? What do you mean Jesus is going to bring them back? Where did they go? It's simple. Paul said in 2 Corinthians 5:8, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. The answer to the question of what happens to a believer when they die is their spirit goes to be with the Lord instantly. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. See, we are a spirit, an eternal spirit, and our spirit goes to be with the Lord when our body dies. Then our body is either placed in the ground or burned up or something else happens to the body. But the real you is with the Lord in heaven. There is no soul sleep. The moment a believer dies, his spirit goes to be with the Lord. Then it gets really good at the rapture. Let's look back at verse 14 again, knowing this information. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus. So what's going to happen at the rapture? Those who have died in faith before the rapture, their spirits are with the Lord. And when the Lord comes back in the clouds, he will bring all of those people with him, all of those spirits with him. And then at the rapture, resurrection, they are going to be realigned with their body. What do I mean by that? Look at verse 15. For this we say to you, by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep or dead. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Here's what's going to happen at the rapture. When the Lord returns in the clouds, he will bring all of those dead, departed believers with him, their spirits back with him. And at the shout of the archangel, the trumpet of God, the dead in Christ will rise first. The dead what? The dead bodies. The dead bodies will be resurrected. They'll be put back together if they've been dissolved to nothing. They'll be put back together and they will be resurrected. They will come out of that grave, these resurrected bodies, and they will be raptured. And they will go up, and the spirits of the departed believers in Christ will be reunited and joined with their resurrected body. Then, I always like to feel that I'm going to be here during the rapture. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up. For us, it will simply be a moment. In the twinkling of an eye, our body will become a resurrected body, a new body, and we will be raptured. And look at this. We will be caught up together with them. Who's the them? The dead in Christ that died before the rapture. In the clouds. We'll all be together. The church will be together in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. It's comforting to know that if you die before the Lord returns, you don't miss out on anything. You won't miss out on anything. You'll be reunited with your resurrected body, and the spirit and the body will be rejoined. And then if you're alive here on the earth, when the Lord returns at the rapture, you'll be changed in a moment, and you'll go up, and all of us will be up there in the clouds with the Lord. The important thing is you must be born again to experience this. Give your heart to Jesus today. Amen. Thanks for watching. If you haven't liked or subscribed yet, please do. Until next time, we'll see you back here on Solving the Prophetic Puzzle.